Well, right now, only about 1,000 people a year visit the island of Kahoolawe. But that number could drop to zero if the island has to close its doors to visitors. Diane Ako visited Kahoolawe and looks at plans for its future in a story you'll only see on KH1 2.
No longer a target for military bombing practice, the island of Kahoolawe is undergoing a slow but steady transformation.
During World War II, every major amphibious assault was first practiced on Kahoolawe by the Pacific Fleet.
Bombs scarred the land for 5 decades, but for 21 years now, crews have cleared some of the ordnance and replanted vegetation. The Kahoolawe Island Reserve Commission, or KIRC, is managing the island until its next owner takes over. It hopes in 10 to 15 years.
The island of Kahoolawe and its waters will be transferred to a sovereign native government. So a lot of what we're doing today is we're trying to establish the foundation for what we believe people would want to have on Kahoolawe when that sovereign entity takes over one day.
In 1993, the federal government granted $44 million to restore the island for cultural and educational purposes. With 1 year left in that fund, KIRC is asking the legislature for $3 million a year. If the money runs out...
We've shut it down, and once we shut this down, I don't think I could ever get it back up and running again.
Naho'opi'i says that would be a shame.
When you come to Kahoolawe, Hawaiian culture is very clear. Because of there's no distractions. You know, it's you, the island, and the other people around you.
The island's isolation is its strength, but also maybe its grim future. In Kahoolawe, with video journalist Ryan Kawamoto, Diane Ako, KHON 2 News.